This video talks about properties of matter, changes in those properties of matter, and temperature curves. So a physical property, it's a property that when it's observed, the identity of the substance doesn't change. Basically the substance changes form, but not identity. Examples of physical properties are the melting point of a substance would be one of its physical properties. So with the boiling point, the color that something is or is observed to be is a physical property, as well as both thermal and electrical conductivities, and the smell, the odor of something. These are all physical properties. When you observe something melting, let's talk about water. When an ice cube melts, it's still water before and water afterwards. It's just solid water, which we call ice, before it melts, and it's liquid water afterwards. It's still H2O. That didn't change. Same thing when water boils. It's a liquid before it boils. It's a gas after it boils. But in both cases, it's still H2O. The color, well, water is colorless, and that is a physical property, the fact that it doesn't have any color. And you can observe that without changing the identity of the water. And it has a certain thermal and electrical conductivity and doesn't have much odor. But if something, when something does have an odor, you would observe that without changing the identity of the substance. Now, a physical change, see the difference here is property versus change. Here, a physical change, it's just one of those physical properties actually happens, okay? And so you observe it. So that the act of ice melting is the physical change, water boiling or smelling perfume. The changes of state that we're going to talk about are going from a solid to a liquid, or a liquid to a gas to a liquid, and you can actually go from a solid direct to a gas and vice versa, from a gas to a solid. The term for going from a solid to liquid, as I'm sure everybody knows, is melting, and the other way around is called freezing. Evaporation is going from a liquid to a gas, and condensation is gas to a liquid. Now, some of you may not know this, though. When a solid goes directly to a gas without becoming a liquid first, that's called sublimation. And when it goes the other way, from a gas directly to a solid, that's called deposition. If you've ever seen dry ice, you've observed sublimation. When you put dry ice, which is solid frozen carbon dioxide, out, you see a fog. That's really water in the air condensing. But it looks like that, if you let it sit there, it looks like it eventually disappears. That's because it's going from the solid carbon dioxide to gaseous carbon dioxide, and you don't see any liquid there. That's why it's called dry. Now, a temperature curve, it can be either a heating curve or a cooling curve. A heating curve, well, both of those, first of all, are a graph of temperature on the y-axis, right over here, and how much energy is added over time on the x-axis. In a heating curve, you're adding energy and the temperature is going up. If we were to draw a cooling curve, it's the same thing, only it's going the other way. You take energy out and the temperature decreases. There's a couple of important properties about temperature curves that you guys need to know. So let's look at them. So we're going to start out, let's imagine this is water. This could be any substance, but let's say it's water. And we start out with frozen water, ice, that's at some temperature below its freezing point, which is 0 Celsius. And so we're right here on the curve. See there? And as we add energy, the temperature of that ice will increase, but it will remain ice. The S here stands for solid. And what this is showing, that every place underneath this line, that's still a solid. The temperature's just increasing. Then when we get to the freezing point for ice, that'll be 0 Celsius, right? Then as we add more energy, then the ice starts to melt. But this is an important point. The temperature doesn't change. When something is changing state, solid to liquid or vice versa, whatever, the temperature stays constant. That's why this line is flat here. The temperature's not increasing or decreasing. And in this region here, under this area of the curve, there's both solid and liquid existing at the same time. And then when we reach this point here, what this point is, this is when we've added enough energy so all of that solid has been melted. And then, okay, they're right here. Okay, so let's look at this, actually. At this point right here, it's all solid and it's 0 Celsius ice. At this point, it's all liquid, but it's still all at 0 Celsius. Then, if we add more energy, the temperature of that liquid will start increasing, and it starts getting warmer and warmer and warmer, and it's all liquid in here, that's what we know. And until we get to this point will be the boiling point, and if it's water, that'll be 100 degrees Celsius. At that point, you have all liquid water, or whatever the substance is, all liquid at its boiling point, water is 100 Celsius. And as we add more energy, the temperature stays constant. So whenever a phase or state changes, the temperature remains constant. And as we add more energy, what happens is some of that liquid becomes a gas. So we have a mixture of liquid and gas in here. And the temperature stays the same until all of that liquid has been converted to gas. So here it's all liquid at 100 Celsius, assuming water. Here it's all gas at 100 Celsius. Then if we add more energy, then the temperature of that gas will start increasing, and we don't really go any farther than this. That's a temperature curve, that, and specifically that's a heating curve. A cooling curve just goes the opposite direction. Now, we talked about physical properties and changes. Now we can talk about chemical properties and changes. A chemical property, it describes the ability of something to change into something else. For instance, iron rusts when you leave it out, and that's a chemical property. It's iron before it happens. Afterwards, rust is a different substance than iron. Propane, when you burn propane, it's propane before you burn it or combust it. Afterwards, it becomes water and carbon dioxide. An acid is corrosive. If you put acid on some metals, you'll dissolve the metals. But in that process, the acid becomes a different substance. That's the difference between chemical and physical. A chemical property describes something changing into something else, whereas in a physical property, it changes, but its identity doesn't change. It's still the same stuff before and after. Now, just like we had physical properties and physical changes, we have chemical properties and chemical changes. So when a chemical change happens, that's the actual process of that substance being converted into something else. And we call this a chemical reaction, which we'll see a lot of later on. For example, iron reacting with oxygen to make rust would be a chemical change, the actual process of that happening. And propane combining with oxygen to make water and carbon dioxide, likewise.